Okay, hey guys, so I thought I'd just put a Mr. Sandman there so the camera had something to focus on for a minute. So today I have a huge Lush haul. Now this is stuff that I got from Facebook groups, from like D-Stash pages. I got a few things off of eBay, and there's actually, if you look really closely, you can find some people that sell things on eBay for what it would cost. What it would cost normally. Like, I've been ordering from the UK this week. I don't know how you guys do it with ordering from the UK if you're in the United States, but getting up at 2 a.m. every morning has been rough. Like the first, I think I ordered last night and the night before, and I'm ordering tonight as well. So yeah, waking up at, or setting my alarm at 1:55 so that I can get up and make sure that I'm like ready to go at 2 a.m. is crazy. I don't know how you guys do it every week. I'm not going to be doing it every week for sure. But there were just some things this week that I really wanted. Where was I going with that? Oh yes, what I was going to say is that ordering from the UK, you have to consider the shipping costs and ordering every night. So like when I look on eBay, I try to consider the cost of the product and also the cost of shipping from the UK into my price factoring. So most of these things, I mean, some things are outlandishly overpriced, and I would highly recommend, you know, not supporting those people. But there are some actually like decently honest eBayers that, you know, they have to make a little bit of a profit because eBay sucks some out of them, and so does PayPal. So they do have to jack up the price a little bit. But honestly, I would rather have something from the UK come from somebody in the United States so I don't have to worry about damaging and all that. I have had good luck with ordering from the UK so far though, so I can't really complain about that. We'll just see how it goes. But I did just want to throw that like disclaimer out there, because I know some of the people on the Facebook groups really get on to eBay sellers, but I think that's just for people who are like extravagantly pricing things. So the first thing that I had to get was, let's just jump in because this is already, I've already been rambling, is Plum Rain. Now I saw Lush a lot talk about Plum Rain probably, oh, I don't know, like a week or so ago. Like, I don't think this was a new post or anything. It was an older one. But, oh, you can see where I already tried it. You can see the product. Okay, so Plum Rain. This smells amazing. When I got my hands on one of these, I was like, holy crap, I have to find more because it is just such a delicious scent. So this says, the rains have arrived, bringing rich, fresh plum juice and, ooh, dang it, I don't know. Umboshi infusion for succulent fruity cleanses. And if you look on the back, so I guess maybe that's prunus is the actual plums, I don't know, whatever. Okay, so you can just see the ingredients there, all good, they all look pretty good. I mean, there's obviously some that are like sodium lauryl sulfate, not happy about that, but I mean, it's the closest you're gonna get to a good product. This is like, oh, like you definitely smell plum, but it's not like the plum you would smell like in a scented type product. It's like real fresh plums, and it kind of has like this floral undertone to it. Kind of a little bit fruity, kind of sweet. Oh, it just smelled so good when I first got it. I was just like, this is not something that you're gonna get at Bath & Body Works that's like plum scented, you know? So, love that. So I did grab two. Not sure, I think I got it from two different sources actually. I feel like I have a third somewhere. I don't know, we'll get to that in a second. The next one I have is, I had to get another 29 High Street. I just did. It is such a good scent. This is like, I don't know how Lush does it, but seriously, they somehow got the scent of like bath bombs into a shower gel. Like, do you guys like the scent of bath bombs? Like, I love to just sniff bath bombs, even if I don't necessarily love the scent. There's something in the undertone of bath bombs that just smells so good to me, and they got it in this shower gel. Like, I am freaking in love. Ugh, it's just everything. It's like all the scents put together. And then bath bomb, like somehow they got the scent of bath bomb in here. It is just so good, so, so good. So there's what it says about it. I won't read it. There you go. And the ingredients. Now you see jasmine is the first ingredient, but I honestly don't get, like, I don't think it's like a heavy, potent jasmine. Yeah, it's not at all. It's so good. 29 High Street. Okay, the next thing I got, I think my friend, I want to say my friend Lauren, had kind of got me to think about this one a little bit more. This is Ponche or Ponch. I don't know. Not sure how to pronounce that. But this is a tequila and orange juice scent. Now, I'd heard they had taken the vodka out. And I heard people kind of complaining that it didn't smell as good as the original. So I don't know if this is one that's new or if they added the tequila back in. This one I'm having a hard time smelling in the bottle. It does smell good what my nose smells. I can kind of smell like an alcohol undertone, but it's really, really nice. Oh, it has cinnamon infusion in it as well. Huh, that's cool. This is the ingredients if you're curious. So we've got more plum in here. That's odd. Cinnamon, fresh orange juice, Davana oil, Buchu oil, petite. Oh, no, not petite. Peta grain oil. I don't know, you guys. I'm so sorry. I'm like totally messing this up, but there's that. So that one smells amazing as well, and I'm glad that she, I'm pretty sure that's the one that she mentioned. She also said Glog. I think I have Glog coming. I know. I don't even know what I have next to me here. I went on like a, if you guys watch my wax videos, I have not been hauling wax whatsoever, so I've had more fun money. You know, instead of spending on wax, I've been spending it on Lush, so. So this next product, I already take the lid off. This is Honey I Wash the Kids Shower Jelly. And so this just smells just like the shower gel. Oh, and this smells amazing. I mean, this smells exactly like Honey I Wash the Kids. Ah, oh, yes, it just smells so good. Mmm. Beautiful, beautiful scent. So I'm getting my hand, like, when I first got these products, I used them, so they still have some of the product, like, coming off the sides, especially, like, these shower jellies get really messy. I need to rinse them off in some water, you can kind of see. So that's kind of just the ingredient list. And, yeah, okay. I have my window open, so if I'm, like, being kind of quiet, it's just so that, I mean, not that my neighbors could hear me or anything, but I don't want them to think I'm nuts over here talking to myself. So the next thing that I got was a Honey Lumps bath bomb. And this came from the kitchen, but this came from a seller who was destashing. So there's kind of the ingredients. It's got honey, tangerine, myrrh, resinoid, and benzoin. Benzoin, resinoid? I don't know. This is what the bath bomb looks like. It's got Lush on the top. This is a honey floral scent. I already know what I'm gonna cocktail this with. It just smells really good. Mm, yes. Can't wait to put that to use soon. Okay. The next thing that I got is Centenary soap. I missed it in the kitchen when it was there. This was there on the February 1st is when it was on there. I guess the UK puts their numbers backwards like than we do here in the US. So this is actually February 1st. So I love their soaps and I love rose jam. This, you can't, I don't know if you can see it through the packaging, but it's like a flower shape. Oh, it smells delicious. It really, really does. It smells amazing. Okay. So that's a few boxes. This is just insane. I will do demos on these products, so that's why I'm not taking them out of the package. But so this is Two Timing Tarte Bubble Bar. And I want to say this is like a strawberry Oh, you know what? This smells like... Oh, this scent smells very familiar. What are you? Oh, hell. I know what this is, but I can't think of it off the top of my head. So, two-time entire bubble bar. So, it's coconut, cream, and jasmine. Oh, and strawberry tart. What is that? Oh, that's going to drive me nuts. I'm sure somebody will know. I'm sure somebody will tell me in the comments. So anyways, it's just this little pink bubble bar, and I thought it would make a really pretty bath. Okay, this kind of is a mess, but I don't know how I feel about this product yet. I ripped it open, and the seller that I bought it from, I asked her, I was like, is this how you got it? Because it looked like in the package. I'm not going to show you the whole package because it just looks a hot mess, but this is Banana Moon Soap. And I'm not really getting, like, I was really wanting it for the banana. I remember when it was in the retro section, and I had always looked at it and wanted to grab it, but then they did away with the retro section, and I never got a chance to try it, so. Yeah, it's just not very, I don't know. I'll have to get it in the shower and see. But it's very, like, soft, and it was kind of sticking to the paper of the product. What am I trying to say? The soap was sticking to, like, the paper, the kitchen paper. Here, screw it. I'll just show you. See, it's, like, all, like, yellow and, like, kind of ripped. Sorry, I'm, like, back here sniffing. It's supposed to smell like bananas, but I'm not getting a strong scent. So, it's kind of an older product. It was made in 5/12/2016, so we'll see. We'll get it in the shower and see. I've been looking at this for a long time. I've been wanting to try this Glorious Mud Body Mask. This is another soap, but it's like clay. I'm pretty sure there's some sort of clay in here. Yeah. Oh, no, mud. So, right there. Let's see if I can. Rasool Mud. God, I'm going to be mispronouncing everything. Sesame oil, aloe vera, vanilla absolute, myrrhizinoid, Brazilian orange oil, and it smells, actually it smells like chocolate, like an orange chocolate. It smells amazing though. I can't wait. I wanted something like to put on my body that, I don't know, that was just good for it, so there's that. And it's just this big block, like, I don't know if you can see on the top there, it's just a big block of, looks like chocolate. Okay, I think that was it out of that box. Okay, so then this one lady, she had two shower gels that I was interested in. And then she's like, hey, I've got, oh geez, are you kidding me? Oh my gosh, okay, I'm so embarrassed. Anyways, she's like, oh, you want these two bottles? I have like six more shower gels I'm trying to get rid of. Are you interested? So I ended up buying two more shower gels off of her, and I was like this sneaky little snake. I'm just kidding. She's very nice. She is very sweet, and she sold them to me for a good price. So the first one is, I don't want to pronounce this, Uluru. So this is supposed to resemble an Australian sunset. I remember when they had this in a bath bomb. And they did away with it. And I remember it made this beautiful bath. But, so this is, let's see. Lemon lathers and dusky sandalwood. But it's more complex than that. I don't know. Anyways, so this is what we have going on. We have organic lemon infusion. Fine sea salt. I'm just reading the things that are, like, important. Lemon myrtle. Oil, Brazilian orange oil, sandalwood, macadamia nut oil, gardenia extract. This is slightly, this is pretty lemony. I remember when I got it though, you can kind of smell that sandalwood, so it kind of made it a little bit better for me. Because if you know from like watching my wax videos, I'm not a huge lover of lemon, but in shower gels, you know, it's good. I don't know why I'm like trying to get this like perfect. Okay, so the next one is, when I saw this, I was like, yes, I need more Butterball. This one, if you ever see this on a, from somebody selling it or whatever, this is crazy. This one doesn't like lather up like a shower cream or like a regular shower gel. It's more like a, well, it's more like a thick cream is what it is. And it doesn't really lather. It just kind of goes on your skin. But it freaking smells just like Butterball. And seriously, the way that they got this to smell like Butterball is beyond me. See if you can kind of see. And just squeeze it. See how it, see how thick that is? I mean, that is thick. It smells just like Butterball. It is freaking amazing. Love that one. Okay, so then the seller put these in bags. So I got another 29 High Street. Holy crap. And a third Plum Rain. I seriously do not know how in the hell I ended up with all those. Like I said, the lady came back and she's like, hey, since I'm already selling these to you, I've got two other things that I could send you. And I was like, oh, great. What is this? Oh, you know what? Oh, I'm so sorry. I feel so bad. I bought something from somebody and they sent me a Sultana body conditioner at the bottom. I didn't even see it. Oh, man. Oh, wow. That smells good. I'm so upset that I did not tell this person thank you. I didn't even see the Sultana body conditioner on the bottom. Anyways, that's that. I was dying to try some body conditioners. Now, eBay on the body conditioners has these jacked up to, like, a lot of people are selling them for, like, $65. It's insane. Don't buy them. That just encourages people to keep, like, the prices high on that. Okay, and then I had to grab another Heavenly Bodies buttercream. I'm going through my other one fairly fast. This just smells just like Sonic Death Monkey. The coffee chocolate scent. It smells really good. I love this. Yes, this has orange blossom, but it smells like chocolate coffee to me. So that is that. Okay, and the last thing that I have is a de-stash from a girl that I actually know from the wax world, and she was very sweet. She actually reduced the price for me. Okay, so I saw it listed, and I was asking about some of the expiry dates because I didn't want to buy, like, I don't want a lot of things like that are close to expiration. You know, I want them to last a little bit. So I was like, well, what are the, some of the expiration dates? And some of the things were expired, and I was just like, you know, I'll pass. So then I said, but if, you know, the other girl that's interested doesn't end up buying it, let me know. And, you know, I'll rethink it or whatever. So she ended up lowering the price for me, which was really cool and really sweet of her. So, and I was excited to get my hands on some different things. She also buys from different countries. I believe she was overseas for a bit. So she had a chance to purchase some things that were, I know she bought some things from Japan. And I know this is expired. So this comforter shower gel, and it's in, I don't know if that's Japanese or Chinese or whatever, but oh, it's probably Japanese since it's from Japan, duh. But I don't know, maybe sending it to my, I have no idea what any of this says. So I guess Japan has a kitchen. I didn't even know that. I don't even know what any of this says. But comforter, I've never had the comforter in shower gel before, so I thought, you know, if anything, like, I don't really love the scent of this. It's kind of almost got like a sweet bubblegum, kind of tart. It smells like a sweet bubblegum to me. And I think this has almond oil in it. I'm not sure because I can't read the ingredients, but I think it does. And my skin does not agree with almond oil. So I might actually give that to my daughter. Or was it this that had almond oil in it? I think we're okay on this. So this came from, where did this come from? I don't know. Can anybody tell me what language this is. Is this German? Or is it Dutch? I don't see anywhere where it says. That's interesting. I wonder if they do that thing. Nope. If you look under your... Oh, wait a minute. I don't know. I'm not going to try to open that. Okay, so anyways. So this is beautiful shower gel. And I think that's German. That looks German to me. I don't know. So beautiful. I got this in a sample and I really loved the scent of it. Oh, and it has glitter in it too. Now I had asked on one of the Facebook groups and everyone was like, yeah, it smells like cat pee. I don't find that. So maybe when I get it in the shower, it won't smell so good. Now some of the things are from this D-Stash are a little bit roughed up, which is fine with me. I trust this person that I bought it from, so I'm not really worried about it, but I think she just wanted to get rid of it. I think she just had too much or whatever. So I don't know what this is. I think I need to use this soon though, because it's, I don't know, I didn't open it, but what is in here? Oh no, I guess nothing bad. Okay. I don't know. Okay, so this is Romance and Estelle Bath Bomb. So obviously I didn't open it. I'll probably do a demo of this because I have no idea what this is supposed to look like, but it's just a floral scent to me. I don't, like, I'm obviously not going to have exact scent descriptions. Okay, so this one's kind of messy, so I'm going to be really careful with this. This I'm going to put in the shower like ASAP. It kind of leaked on in transit, but from what I've seen from people, this is really like watery. But this is Nightwing Shower Jelly, and it's supposed to smell like, is it Calacus or Calacus? I don't know. It's the shower gel that Lush makes. And it smells a little bit different to me though. I'm not going to open it just because I don't want to mess with it, but it smells different to me than the shower gel I just said. I'm not going to try to repronounce it because I'll jack it up. But it's this like beautiful like black bat, but I really want to get it in the shower. So she also sold me a fairy dust dusting powder. And so this is obviously the scent of Snow Fairy. Is that right? Snow Fairy? And chew. Okay. Just trying to see. I haven't, like, when I got this, I didn't really, like, look at it too well. Like, I just kind of checked. Oh, that smells good. It's been a long time since I've had Snow Fairy. I remember it smelling very bubblegum-y. So, fairy dust, dusting powder. I like using these on, like, in my vacuum. I know that sounds terrible, but I like sprinkling a little bit on the floor and sucking it up in my vacuum cleaner, and it just smells, like, really amazing. So, we'll stick that there. Okay, and then she also sold me a Christingle body conditioner, and I had really wanted to try this. Oh, this is another one that's from another country. I didn't even know that. That is so weird. That is crazy. I don't even know what the... I can't even tell what this, like, dates are that you're supposed to use. Anyways, I've already dumped into it, but it's this blue, and it's a body conditioner, and it just smells like a peppermint type of scent. So I'm going to use this for shaving, see how it goes. It might be too strong for shaving. It might kind of burn, so I'm not sure. I might just use it as it is intended, as a body conditioner. But okay, the other thing that I got from her is this thing is huge. This is a mumkin, and if you've guys seen a mumkin, I don't have to take it out of the wrapper. You know what mumkin looks like. Just a cute little, oh, it smells good. And so this is another Japan, I guess, kitchen, Japan kitchen item. It's supposed to have a certain scent to it, but I'm not smelling that right now. I'm trying to remember what mumkin is supposed to smell like, and honestly, I don't remember. It smells good. I mean, it smells like a Lush product, pretty much. It's funny because I bought two bar humbugs from the same girl. the last time she did a de-sesh, like a month ago maybe, this bath bomb, this bubble bar smells amazing. I had the best bath with this, and I cocktailed it with a Lord of Misrule bath bomb. It seriously was like the most refreshing bath. Relaxing. This bar made a ton of bubbles, and they were thick. I had like a mountain of bubbles. It was amazing. Okay, and then I'm not going to open this one because this is, just Tisty Tosty bath bomb. So there's not really too much to say about that. We all have seen Tisty Tosty. So I haven't had Tisty Tosty in a long time. Like the first time I found Lush, that was probably one of the first things I ordered. Okay, so then she also had Snow Showers Shower Jelly. And I think this is supposed to be celebrating. I'm loving the jellies right now, so... yeah, oh, that's good. That's celebrate scented. Ah, that smells good. I have to get that in my shower. In fact, I need to get all of her products in the shower because I'm pretty sure a lot of them were close to expiration date. So she also sent me also in the de-stash was Mellow Mint Bubble Bar. This one smells amazing. It's very minty. Yeah, that's good. That's really good. I think she sold me another one of these as well a while back. So, what is this? Okay, this is Down the Rabbit Hole Bubble Bar. This, try to be careful because this one kind of got... packaging is not very like, so that is Down the Rabbit Hole Bubble Bar, and this one came from, oh, this one actually came from the UK kitchen. This smells good. I have no idea what the scent description is supposed to be, but this one will be, oh, I can't wait to use that one. That will be nice. Like I said, I need to use up her products pretty darn quick. Okay, so this one, I'm not going to take it out. It looks a hot mess in here, but whatever. I believe this is Karma Bath Melt. And you can kind of see it got a little melty in there. I'm sure she's had this for a while. It just smells just like Karma, of course. Okay. Just a couple more things. Oh, this was another product that when she had listed the de-stash, I was like... this is another retro item that a long time ago I really wanted to try this. Oh, okay, I need to go put these in my shower like right now. I need to like move everything else out and put all this older stuff in there so that way I use it up. But this 17 Cherry Tree Lane smells amazing. This is part of the retro line when it was around and they got rid of it. So this was made on 3/16/2015. Their soaps last a really long time, so I'm not too concerned about the soaps. Like I said, she gave me a really discounted price, so I'm not going to complain. Okay, so the next thing that was in the de-stash is Angel's Delight Soap, and it is this huge, huge moon, which I think is super cool. So this was made on 12/21/15. It's from the Lush Kitchen, and it says, "Sweet like jelly babies, this shimmering moon soap has come back down to earth for a few short days." So this has tangerine, orange... what else? Radiant Gold Luster on it. I don't know. I'm not... like, it has a very unique scent. And I don't quite know how to describe it. It does have, like, the citrus notes to it. But then it's like, backed up by something else. Like, it says it has perfume. So, I'm guessing they must have some sort of perfume that makes it some sort of, you know... anyways, this is Angel's Delight Soap. And with that, I think that is finally it. So if you guys can translate any of that stuff, like if you can tell me what language that is, if it's German, that would be great. Because I have no idea. Where was the other thing that was made? I know that that's Japan. I don't know. I can't find the other thing. But anyways, yeah, that is my huge Lush haul from de-stashes and Facebook groups and a few things off of eBay. So yeah, so like I said, I have some more coming. I have some UK kitchen stuff that I ordered, and then what else? I think I have something coming today, but I have plenty of products now. I feel like I kind of went like crazy. It's like I haven't had Lush for a long time, and then like kind of once I got back into it, I was like, holy crap, like I just missed it like a whole bunch. So anyway, so I think I'm pretty good. I've been taking baths on the regular basis as well, so these products are definitely getting used up like ASAP. So, and I will be doing, or sorry, ASAP, ASAP. I will definitely do demos on some of these products. I like doing the bath demos. I have some bath demos up on my channel already. I have some from a long time ago, and then I have some newer ones. So if you're interested in seeing some of the products, go check it out. Okay, I will talk to you guys later. Thank you so much for watching, and yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Okay, bye.